things I'm real before?
Test before.
Do you use it like often or do it for VR stuff?
No.
Okay, then this won't be boring for you lah. Okay, so this is the Unreal Launcher. Hold on, let me take out my notes. Okay, on the left side, there are four tabs. Community tab is like the news tab. Then the Learn tab is where you can find all the tutorials, demos. Some of the demos contain free assets, and the assets are pretty high quality. And you can find stuff like Know Your Showdown, VR, the project is there. Then there's also the Marketplace tab. You can buy Marketplace assets. If you come from Unity, you will notice that the Unity Marketplace is actually much bigger than this. But the quality of assets here, they are usually higher. The price is also higher though. Then next, this is a library. This is where usually you will launch, you can find all your projects and some of your assets that you bought from the Marketplace. So for this, let's go through the 4.11. You need to use this to make your project work on the CV1 Oculus.
So you have multiple versions installed, and you can install as many versions as
you like? Yes, you can install as many versions as you like. Just point out, there's actually a 4.12 version where if you read the news before, you can actually use the editor in VR mode. So you can put on the Rift or HTC and use editor. Anyway, back to the 4.11. So this is like the most stable version right now. And for the demo, I think I'll use the first person demo project. Okay, so this is what the Unreal Editor looks like. On the left side, it's the content browser where you can find the most of the assets. Then in the middle is the viewport. On the top of the viewport, there are some settings options for the viewport. For example, you can change it to unlit, wireframe, or shader complexity. Yeah. And this might be important, like if you want to see what in your scene is causing some lag or reduction in frame rate, you might want to try this. Then on the right side, they are more about the settings of the actors in the scene. So for example, this is a cube in the scene, and you can see that those are the materials that you can change. Yeah. And some settings about that you need to change when you first launch a project. Oh, thanks. Okay, maps and modes are important. I'll come back to this later. So something useful is like the input settings where you can just map all your keyboard buttons or your gamepad patterns to some of the functions. It's a bit more convenient to have it here. And for VR, it's important that you go to rendering. Go all the way down. Epic Games, they have recently implemented this instance zero option. Where they claim to improve efficiency by about 30% if you enable it. So I enable it. Back to the control. So these inputs are actually mapped to your blueprints. And in Unreal Engine, you have this thing called a blueprint where you can basically program or code for your game or for your project. So instead of using C++, you can do something like this. This is a form of visual scripting. It's mainly node-based. Okay. So for example, if you want to maybe code like fire or some particle effects, you can just link it to, and you can link it to maybe a button like Q, and you can just spawn whatever effects you want to. So something like this, and you can do it for almost as many actors in the scene as possible. You can change anything, about just about anything in the scene to a blueprint. So you can select a few of these and convert them into a blueprint. Some parts of the scene that I want to highlight that is important to make your scene look nicer in general. Hold on. If you notice in the new project, they give you atmospheric fog, light sources, in the sky sphere, so you should change some of this, but it's important to add in stuff like the exponential height fog and the post-process volume.
Can I explain what's post-processing volume?
It's basically some settings to make to change the view of your scene. So, for example, your bloom, your flare, and motion blur.
Okay.
Yeah. And for VR, there's something that you need to do, which is to disable the AO. This greatly improves the efficiency for your VR games. Okay. Then I'll just run through some other features of Unreal Engine. Okay. There's this thing called Martini. It's basically like your cutscene editor or maker, so you can link stuff in your link objects in your scenes to make cutscenes out of them, like maybe some battles, or actually if you want to make a platform move from point A to point B, you can do it through this Martini as well. Okay, and that's one thing important to note for all your VR games. When you're trying to optimize the frame rate, you press a Control Shift comma and it will bring up this GPU visualizer. So, for example, if you are playing or you're testing out a game halfway and you notice that there's some significant drop in frame rate, then you should do this to find out that what's the cause of the lag. And to the right, you can see like the number of the MS that shows like which is taking up more resources. Yeah, and that's how you run into issues when creating a first-person VR game for Unreal Engine. Just some stuff that you're gonna do to the first-person camera. Otherwise, your player will start at ground level, so you gotta increase the height of the player. So you have to add a scene components, attach the first-person camera to the scene components, then add a Z offset. And you should also remember to uncheck the use point control rotation. Otherwise, the VR camera won't be tracking you properly. Okay, so actually that's about it for the brief run through. I have a game that I made using Unreal. Maybe you can try it later after Diane gives his speech. So that's about it for now.
Do you want me to play the beat?
I test it out first, then after the end of everything.
Okay.
I don't know, if you guys are interested, you can see like the Showdown VR demo. I don't know if any of you have tried the Showdown made by Epic Games. So it's just like it's one of the more popular demos out there. I can't see it here. It's available on the Oculus Store as well as a concept. Yeah, maybe later when we set up Oculus.